even when they had people on in California claiming that here's 3 years of my electrical bills, they all say $200 a month. It hasn't changed in 3 years. Now with the smart meter, I'm paying $600 a month. What is going on? And when the utilities are questioned, they said, well, you're using more electricity. They said, no, I'm not. And when the commission said, maybe we should get a third party to go in and check on this, the utility said, no, we'll check on it. Let's see how maybe there's a mistake in her bill. Immediately shut down any discussions of having a third party look into this because they don't want to. Because they know that it is the power switching supply within the smart meter itself that is causing everybody's bill to go up, even though you've done nothing to change your energy usage. What's happening is that switching supply is causing all of this energy to be used up in your home through arcing, and they don't want you to know that. These are all the things that I'm talking about that are readily out there in research, but most people either are not researchers like myself or don't have the scientific background to connect all the dots, which I'm very good at connecting dots. So from the just safety issues of electricity itself, smart meters are extremely bad idea. From the health issues of microwave radiation, smart meters are a bad idea. Saving money. One of the big things that KIUC has promoted, that this is a green technology, that it will save not only, or I should say, they said it could save us money, it could save the consumers money, and it could save the co-op money. They say the word could because they have no evidence that it does. In fact, all of the data from all of the 6 years of smart meters being rolled out all over mainland Canada, Europe, not one utility has saved any money whatsoever. Not one. They have not a single utility that can make that claim. Otherwise, they'd be shouting it from the rooftops. Maine has saved money with smart meters. Nope. California saved money with smart meters. Nope. Texas. Nope. Portland, Oregon. Nope. Canada. Nope. But it could. If I went to Vegas and dropped some money into a slot machine, I could win. And I know for a fact that somebody has won. Otherwise, nobody would drop any money in it whatsoever. And yet, KIUC has dropped $11 million into this without a single winner that they can point to. And I'm still working on those figures, but my estimates right now that to run the whole complete smart meter system on Kauai is over $1 million per year, depending on the price of oil. And if oil goes up, it's going to cost us even more. Who is ultimately responsible to pay for all of this? We are, as the co-op members. It's not billed to us directly, but it is part of the operating expenses of the co-op itself. And we are responsible for that. So there's going to be a little adjustment in there for a few surcharges and such. So in every aspect of the word, there's no reason that they can give to install this other than to make more money. That's the only reason I can see for installing a smart meter, because it gives them not only a base that your electric bill will go up because of arcing, but also their infrastructure is going to cost more, so the electric bill goes up because of the infrastructure cost. And also, they want to introduce what is called peak hour demand. They're saying they're not going to, but we know this is where it's heading. So that the peak hours of between 3 p.m. and 7 p.m., you will be charged much higher rates than what you currently do. And they will rake in even more money. Which is an affront to every family here on Kauai that doesn't have a choice on when they use electricity. A lot of families here, because of our economy, because it's so expensive to live in Hawaii, that's the time when the kids come home from school. That's when the time you can do all their laundry. That's when you can do all the cooking. That's when the TV goes on, the water heater goes on, all of these other things. You really can't change that time frame. I've got two kids. Between 2 and 6 o'clock, that's the busiest time of my day. Laundry, cooking, dinner, cleaning, entertaining the kids before they go to bed, getting them bathed, and all of that. I can't change any of that. There's no way. That's just when I can do it. So now I am being punished to have a family. Literally being punished because I have a family. Families are the most vulnerable group in every study ever done in the U.S. Families are the most vulnerable group to peak demand them because they have no choice. It reminds me of what they used to do with the phone bill. Before cellular phones were very, very popular, there was demand, peak demand phone hours. So that you'd have to pay a lot more when everybody was talking, and then give you really great rates after 9 o'clock. So everyone would have to wait till after 9 o'clock. But there was really no reason for them to do that other than it made a lot of money for them. The electrical industry as a monopoly is copying that system because they know it's a verified money maker, and they want to do the same thing here on Kauai. They already make too much money as is. We are the highest, we have the highest electrical bills in the nation, on Kauai, in the whole nation, which makes no sense whatsoever. And the only reasons why we're told on why it's so high is because, oh, it's because we live in Hawaii. We have the highest bills because of the shenanigans that they keep doing by wasting our money. How much money have they wasted on the FERC process? Millions upon millions of dollars of our money. How much money are they going to be wasting on this project? The smart meter initiative or the smart meter upgrade or whatever term that they want to use, but really it is a pilot project. Go to page 6 on their pamphlet, you see it in bold letters on page 6, which most people never get to. But it is a pilot project that has been tested on Oahu and failed, that has been tested on Maui and failed, because it doesn't do anything that they say it will. And yet the PUC allowed KIUC to go forward with it. Why? I don't know. The problem lies in all of the new technology they keep putting out there that is untested. The tried and true technology works for 50 years or more at a time. They're bringing in untested technology that's being pushed upon them and actually given to them via federal grants. Now you got to remember, the smart meter installation has been, KIUC has been given a grant from NRECA, $5.5 million. And NRECA was given a grant from the government of $33 million.
You know, one of the things that I haven't heard anybody talk about, and it's too late now because the $11 million is already spent. That was told to me by one of our board members. The money's been spent. Can't get that back. But if they had done some research, that would have provided over 11,000 photovoltaic panels for additional electricity without burning diesel fuels.
That's right.
And 11,000 panels would be a heck of a lot of electricity.
Oh, they could have done that. They could have bought solar water heaters for every home on the island and still have change. They could have done this a huge number of different ways in order to actually make a real impact on the energy issues here on Kauai, but they didn't, because they never approached the co-op membership with what they were doing. They did this all behind closed doors. Electrical utility companies throughout the nation are stand to make a huge profit. In California alone, the PG&E, Pacific Gas and Electric Company, they've announced profits that are, I think, 40% up from last year.
Because members' bills have gone up.
Member bills has gone up. in all of these instances, and it's a proven fact that 80% of your customers, wherever smart meters have gone in, their bills have gone up, anywhere from $40 a month up to $200 a month. It's ridiculous. I've read their tax returns and it's scary. It's ridiculously scary. I haven't seen their 2011 tax return, but on the 2010 tax return of a company that has approximately 160 plus or so employees, over 50 of them make over $100,000.
What?
So on their tax return, and that's from 2011. I don't know what it is on now, for, I mean, 2010. Now at 2011, I don't know if it's gone up or gone down, but I do know because of my connections in there, they are very well paid. They are under a huge amount of stress all the work, but they are very well paid to keep quiet.
Did the tax return say how much rent they pay?
The tax return does say how much rent they pay. Let me see if I can get this straight. They pay the highest rent, I think, in the state for per square foot than anybody else.
$90,000, isn't it, a month?
I think, believe it's like $90,000 a month, almost $1 million, over $1 million a year. By standing up, by saying no, you completely short circuit the whole thing.
Clean up your
and own all it takes is one person to stand up and say no. That's all it takes. And then others notice it. And now you have this whole ripple effect going outwards. Because one person touches another person, touches another person. My sister-in-law alone has touched hundreds of people with this. Just one person has touched hundreds. So even though you may only communicate the information to one person, you don't know how many people that person is going to touch. And that's the power that we have right now by just standing up and saying no and presenting the actual facts to the public. Thank you.